session deals with this main four topics: types of gears, interference, undercutting, and problems related to this interference. First, let us go for types of gears. So let me consider this. So you can able to see some figures, right? So this is figure 1, figure 2, and figure 3, right? Can you see any differences in these gears?
Second one, sir.
Second one.
Yeah, second one. Very good. So actually, second one and first one are same related type of single type of same type of gear. And third one is different. The first two we called as a cycloidal gears. Sorry, I can't able to write it correctly. So this is cycloidal type of gear. So this is this gear profile was taken from a cycloidal curve. Hope you are studied something in engineering drawing, right? So the path traced, so a path traced by a point, right? So when the wheel is rotating in a horizontal plane or in a an external round shape, so you call that as a cycloid, right? So of course they you'd have done something called as epicycloid and hypocycloid. There are two cycloidal gears, so epicycloid and hypocycloid. So this gear profile is identified by means of epicycloid. So this is for epicycloid and this one is hypo, right? So because hypo is rotating inside a particular bigger circle, right? So and epic is outside, right? When so the profile traced by the particular point, based on that you got this cycloid, okay? And this one, 3, is involute profile, right? So that also you studied something in your engineering drawing. So what happens when the path is traced from a point when it is unwounded? So when a thread is being wounded on a particular any object, if you unwound the thread, what is the path traced by that, right? That is what we call it as a involute. So you would have a doubt. So why we study these things? Why this we are modeling this involute, cycloid, epicycloid, hypocycloid? So actually, it deals with this gears, right? So the main concept is, so the profile is taken from this particular types of what you can say, involute and cycloids. Based on that path, we are taken what is the profile for this. Okay, so when you consider here, so a cycloidal gear is something which you to be concentrated. So the curve, whatever the curve is traced based on the diameter of the gear, right? Whatever you consider, right? So based on the diameter only, we can able to get that particular curve, right? So okay, so let me consider here. So I think that slide has been mismatched. Okay, this is a involute type of profile. So what you can say is there is a line which is there is a string which is passed through that. So when you consider this, this profile has been taken, right? So based on this involute profile, so you get that particular curve it is. That curve we call it as an involute curve, right? So and this is for cycloid, right? You can able to see. So this is for hypocycloid. And this is for epicycloid. So this is a bit circle of the bigger diameter circle, right? When you roll a gear on that particular circle, it is tracing a point. So you can able to see the point traced by this one. So you have a path, right? So this path is used to identify. You can able to see here. So this path is used to draw this profile. Okay. So that is what we call it as a cycloidal type of gear tooth, right? So let me show a particular video so where you can understand, right? This was taken from science tech science. So I think just a minute. Yeah, can you able to see? Is it playing?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So this is for cycloid. So how it is traced. Now you can able to see, right? So how this profile has been created, okay? So this, of course, it is mainly depends on the pitch circle diameter of any gear, right? So for example, if I want a gear, two gears, right, in a cycloidal type of profile, right? So first you should know what is the pitch circle diameter of both the gear, right? Then only you can able to identify what is the profile, right? What is the profile? It is it will be changed differently. So when you change the gear diameter, for example, this is my pinion, right? So if it is 20 mm diameter, let me consider, right? So I can't fit a 30 mm diameter or 25 mm diameter gear here, because the profile of these two gears is matching with the 20, right? Actually, right? So this is mainly what I can say is it is like you can't change it directly, right? So I can't get that word actually, right? So it is like whatever the profile which is created, it is dependent on each other, right? So both the profiles is dependent. So any gear, whatever you do, if you make a single mistake in any of the design, then it makes a lots of cost. What happens is you have to change the entire gear system and you have to change that profile also, right? That is the main disadvantage of the cycloid, right? But when you look after the advantage, I think the vibration is lesser when compared to involute, right? And of course, this will transmit, so you can able to see that. So this is mainly used in type of locations where you have to pump some fluid, right? Gear pump. And so for that particular type of locations, you use this cycloidal gear, right? But involute is not like that. So involute is independent of the diameter of the tooth. That's why most of the gears we use involute profile, right? Which means instead of 20 mm, if I take 30 mm, only based on module I can fit it. So only module has to be same, right? Other than this, you no need to worry about the other profiles and all. So involute will fit directly, right? So related to whatever dimensions your gear is. But cycloid is not like that. It should form the same dimension. For particular dimension, the profile will be different. For every dimensions, there you will get a different profile, right? That is the disadvantage for this cycloid, right? So any doubt in this?
Sir, in one sir, can you repeat?
Yeah.
One more, sir. When you told that have to mesh two gears itself, then the two gears module should be same, no, sir?
Yeah.
So indirectly, pitch circle diameter should be same only, no, sir? Then how, sir, the involute?
No. Not pitch circle diameter. Circular pitch.
Yes, sir.
It is not pitch circle diameter, circular pitch. So your circular pitch should be same.
Yes,
can
sir.
You able to get it?
Yes, sir.
Right? If that is the case, it will mesh and it will work.
Okay, right? Sir.
But this is not in the case of cycloid.
Yes, sir.
Right? So your teeth profile is purely, so we don't know what is the amount of teeth you will get. For example, if I want to increase the number of teeth, that can be done in involute. But cycloid, you can't able to do that. So for a particular diameter, whatever based on the meshing gear, how many teeth it is formed, that only can be calculated. That only is applicable, right? So that is the main disadvantage and advantages. Can you get it?
Yes, sir.
Yeah.
Sir, is it like that?
Right.
Yes, sir. Is it like that? If the profile is cycloid, then both the both pinion and the driven gear pitch circle diameter should be same. Only then it can work.
No. Not pitch circle diameter. The profile. So you look at this picture. In these two pictures, the pitch circle diameter is not same. It is different.
Yes, sir.
Right. It is like, so I have to what I have to lock what is my circular diameter. So for example, this pitch circle diameter and this circle pitch circle diameter, if this two is meshing, you will get a profile.
Yes, sir.
Right? That profile cannot be used if any of this is different.
Okay, sir.
Right? For example, for this two, I got a profile. Instead of this circle, if I take some other circle which is having lesser diameter, it won't mesh.
Okay, sir.
Can you able to get it? Yes, right? Sir. Because the profile was created only based on that particular two,
yes,
mating gears.
So the gears of a cycloidal profile, then one pinion and one driven gear only two distinct can be done. But in case of involute, number of gears can be replaced. You can even replace a pinion or a driven gear.
Yeah, you can easily replace it. Right. So I can reduce my diameters, whatever it is, I can fix it in involute.
So right? When you are choosing a profile of a cycloid, and it is very unique and distinct.
It is very unique. Yes. Yeah. Correct. You are right. So it has to be unique, right? That is why most of the time they won't go for cycloidal type of profiles. So mostly, any gear, if you look after it, it will be an involute type, because you can easily mesh with any pitch diameters, right? So it will fix. Right. So, but it is not applicable for that cycloid. Right. That is the main thing. Right. So we will go for the next topic, which is undercutting. Right. Undercutting is like this is the diagram for this. So when two gears is meshing, right. So let me consider this figure, this blue color figure. So you can able to see here. So there is a mesh in the gear. But what about this is, actually this gear has to be like this. This gear has to be like this. So the teeth, what is this addendum of this particular gear? Let me consider gear 1. When it mates with dedendum of gear 2, right? So what happens? It will lock, right? There is a possibility it will lock so that there is no type of rotation, right? So sometimes it will happen. So in order to avoid that, we undercut this particular gear. So you can able to see. So the profile is like this, right? Actually, this is my profile, right? But what has happened is one simple part, some part has been removed in order to avoid that interference, right? So interference is locking system, which is occurring from the addendum of gear 1 to the dedendum of gear 2, right? So addendum circle, or I can say that addendum circle of gear 1 and dedendum circle of gear 2, right? So when it occurs, there may be a lock in the particular system, right? So to avoid that lock, you will have this undercutting, right? You will have this undercutting. So this undercutting, it is like machining it at a particular distance, at a particular curve, so that it will come out easily, right? So that is the main concept of here, right? So that is what it is indicated. So if the addendum circle of the mating gear, so I told you gear 1, so it is like this, is more than the limiting value, it interferes with the dedum of the pinion, okay? Then two gears get locked, right? So to avoid this, we will remove some material, right? That is what we call as an undercutting, right? So why we go for undercutting? Why can't we reduce the number of teeth? So you may ask a question. For that, this is the answer, right? So if you reduce the number of teeth in a pinion, whatever it is, so what happens? This will weaken the tooth, because the teeth is less, so the contact is also less, so the tooth is somewhat weakened, so that will break easily. Right, so at a particular time it will break easily. So to avoid that only, we are going for this undercut type of option, where the number of teeth is higher, right? But we do some undercutting to match with that. Okay, so there is a possibility where undercutting is not we can't use that when you design a gear to avoid interference, right? You can also design a gear to avoid that interference, right? That is what we are going to discuss, right?
Sure.
So at the beginning stage itself, we are designing it. So instead of going for at the end, what is the whether you have interference or not, at the beginning stage itself, we are designing so that it will avoid that interference. Yeah.
So if the RNM of the mating gear is more than the limiting value, means what is how we will decide that limiting value, sir?
Yeah, the limiting value is length of path of contact. Right? That is what I'm going to discuss in next slide. Right? So it is nothing but length of path of contact. So let me consider here. So you can able to see this is the gear. So I think you can able to see one gear, you don't have any undercutting. Whereas this gear, you have an undercutting. Can able to see the undercutting. Okay, this gear has to be here. So it has been undercutted like this. So this will avoid this interference. Right? So I will show it. So how it is just a rotation. So how it works without any locking. Right? So this is what. So this is done. So when you look at a particular stage to avoid that interference, what you have to do? So you look here. So this is the gear profile. I think it's somewhat, you can able to see. So from M to N, you have a line. That is what we call as a length of path of contact, right? So from M to N, so the thing is to avoid interference, you should have a maximum length of path, that is MN. Up to this MN, you should have that. It should not exceed M1. So if your path is more than this, right? So how it will be more? It depends on the addendum, right? If the teeth, let me consider, this is my teeth profile, right? So it is mainly depends on this addendum, right? So when this addendum is higher, what happens? It will be more than this MN, right? Because that the path traced by this particular point will be more, right? So then it will cause interference, right? So you have to be very, very keen to know that your addendum, whatever value, should be under the limit of MN, right? Which is the path of contact, right? So based on that, we got two more formulas, right? So this is mainly to avoid interference. Just to avoid interference, you can say that length of path of approach will be small r sin phi, length of path of recess will be capital R sin phi. So the total length of path of contact will be so small r plus capital R sin phi. Actually, the formula is different. Root of R A square minus R V R square sin square cos square phi. So right. So that has been removed. So to avoid interference, this has to be the formula, right? So this is one thing. This is another one, right? And the last one. So total length of contact is this R plus R by sin phi, right? R. So actually we won't deal with length of contact. We will go for arc of contact. If you want arc of contact, you have to divide by cos phi. That means my formula will be like this. So sin phi by cos phi is tan phi. So R plus R tan phi, right? So this formula is applicable only under interference, to avoid interference. This is not the formula where you calculate directly. So what is the length of path of contact? Right, that one we will note. So this is a special case formula. So only this, when the question is specified like this, what will be the to avoid interference, what is your point of contact, something like that, then you have to proceed with this. Otherwise you don't consider this formula, right? Any doubt in this,
sir? So this formula is mainly for whether to check whether the maximum the addendum is that's all. So we are just approximating.
Yes, correct. So it has to check as well as you can also identify what is your addendum based on this. Right. So maybe we will solve one problem related to this. Okay. Right. So these are some formulas which we'll be using to identify, right, what is your addendum or what is your teeth. Mostly we will identify what is the addendum, right, sometimes teeth also, right? So what is the addendum and teeth for to avoid interference, right? So have a note of this formula. So small t is equal to 2ap divided by root of 1 plus g into g plus 2 sine square phi minus 1. So minus 1 is not under root, it is outside, right? Same formula, capital T, instead of ap it will be aw, instead of g it will be 1 by g, right? So other things are same. What is this g? G is nothing but a gear ratio, which is capital T by small t. So in some book it will be some length, something in terms of t by t, something like that. So it will be a very, very confusing one. That's why it has been reduced like this, right? And ap is what is your standard addendum, right, to avoid interference, right? What is the standard for a wheel, for a pinion, right? So have a note of this particular formula. We will be solving some problems related to that through these formulas. Okay, so let me go for problem. So what they are asking, so a pair of involutes per gear with 16 degree pressure angle and pitch of module 6 mm is in mesh. So that is what they are given. The number of teeth of the pinion is 16 and its rotational speed, so which means pinion is rotating, right, to a rotation speed is 240 rpm. The gear ratio is 1.75. find in order that the interference is just avoided. The addendum or addenda on pinion and wheel gear, length of path of contact, the maximum velocity of sliding of teeth on either side. What do you mean by either side? Which means approach and recess, right? For that you have to identify what is the velocity. This is the question, right? So let me identify. So what are the given datas, right? Can you tell me the given datas here? So they are given what is the phi value, which is your pressure angle, which is 16 degree, right? Module is given. So M is given. So M is equal to 6 mm, right? Then small t is given.
Small t.
So small t is given, which is 16. Rotational speed, right? This is for pinion, right? Rotational speed for pinion is given. So N for pinion. So I've got NP, right? So which is equal to 240 RPM, right? Next, gear ratio is given. So this is what we call it as capital G. So capital G is given, which is equal to 1.75, right? So these are the things which was given, right? Now we have to think about what are the things which we need to identify, right? So only based on questions, we will identify based on questions, right? So the first thing is addendum, which means they are asking what is AP and AW, right? What is AP and AW, right? Addenda of the pinion and addenda of the wheel, right? Okay. So to identify these things, you have a formula, right? What are the data available for that particular formula? I think small t you have to identify.
G, sir.
Capital T we have to identify.
G.
Pi we have to identify. Anything else?
G, sir.
G, sir.
Yeah, G. Yeah, G. Anything else? So the formula contains these variables, right? I think G is given.
Sir, I'm doubt, sir. Sir, yeah. The formula we read, no, sir. So that is the formula for number of teeth that should be present on the pinion or the wheel, or number of teeth that should be in contact.
No, that should be in pinion or gear. Minimum number of teeth shall just be in pinion or gear. So actually teeth is given here. You have to identify, yes, what is the addendum for this.
Total number of teeth present in the pinion or wheel, not it is not related to how many number of teeth is in contact.
No, 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 no.
Okay, sir.
That is not the case. You can identify to avoid interference, what is the number of addendum, what will be the addendum and dedendum. Of course, this is given actually, right? Because if 16 is given, gear ratio is given, we can identify what is the overall teeth, right? So phi is also given, which you identified. Small t is also given, which is identified. So only thing is you have to identify this capital T. How to identify capital T? We know
using gear ratio.
G is T by T, right? Which is equal to 1.75, which means capital T will be equal to 1.75 into small t. So
28.
16. So capital T will be 28. So we know all these data. So all these things are identified, right? So only thing is, I have to substitute in the formula to identify what is the addenda for pinion and addenda for wheel, right? Then we go for the formula, right? So addenda, so I think it will be small t, right? So small t is equal to 2 into AP divided by root of, so what is the formula?
One plus
root of one plus
g
into
open brackets g plus two,
yeah, g plus two
close brackets sine square phi
minus one, right? So this is the formula, right? So okay, so the unknown data here is AP, right? Let's substitute it. It's all in few steps. Okay. So small t is known, which is 16, is equal to, so 2 into AP divided by root of 1 plus, I think, 1.75 into 1.75 plus 2. Sine square 16 minus 1. Right? So I can cross multiply. I can write 16 into root of 1 plus. So 1.75 into 3.75, right? 1.75 into 3.75. Sine square 16 minus 1 is equal to 2 AP. Right? What is the answer for this particular term?
AP is coming as 1.7933
mm.
This term alone.
Tell me for this one. Right hand side, what will be the answer?
Sir, 0.224167. That root minus 1. The denominator part alone, 0.224167.
This one is 0.2247.
Yes, sir. 0.224167.
This alone are the entire term.
This minus one. That bracket alone. That bracket fully, I am telling, sir.
Okay. 16 into
0.224167.
0.22414167. Okay, is equal to 2 into AP. Right? So what is your AP? So AP will be equal to 16 into 0.2244167 divided by 2. So it will be how much?
1.7933 mm.
Any doubt in this? So addendum for pinion is 1.793 mm. Right? So next, for a gear. So for the next one is, I have to identify for addendum for wheel. So capital T is 2 into AW divided by, similar to that. Right, so the formula will be 1 plus 1 by g into 1 by g plus 2 sine square phi. Of course, this has to be in root, right? Minus 1. So I think capital T is 28. 2 into AW divided by. So can you solve this? So root of 1 plus 1.175 into 1.175 plus 2. Sine square 16 degree, sorry. Minus 1. Yeah. So, okay, I will discuss how to identify what is the addendum. Actually, this is not addendum. This is with respect to one module. That is what they mentioned. So, what you have to do is, we have to identify what is the addendum based on this. Okay, that we will discuss in next class.